Hi everybody and welcome to a new weekly vlog. It is Monday if I am not mistaken and my day... What day is it?
Tuesday.
It's not Tuesday.
It is Tuesday.
Where did Monday go?
It was yesterday.
Where on earth did Monday go? It's Tuesday. Welcome to Tuesday. I literally thought it was... I've lost a whole day. I think I have erased Monday completely from my memory. Anyway, Matt is reliably informing me. It's Tuesday.
Yeah.
So here we are, and we've just premiered last week's weekly vlog, so thank you for everyone who turned up to the initial premiere, and of course to everyone who's watched on Catch Up Later. Thank you so much for all of your comments. I'm going to turn the camera around and show you what we're up to. So, as usual, we find Matt in the kitchen preparing a delicious meal.
The only time you saw me in the last vlog was when I was cooking.
Yeah, but we actually said how much cooking you actually did. Mm. There was a lot of cooking. A lot of deliciousness and yumminess going on. So, what are we having today?
We're having peri peri chicken in some pita breads with some salad. That's what you're going to do.
Okay.
And some chips.
And we're using this. It's a Flavour It classic peri peri no fuss mix.
When I was a single man, I used to live off Flavour It.
I know.
I would just eat chicken and pasta, but I'd have the different flavourings.
Yeah, but you like plain pasta without anything on it. Mm. I'm not keen on just plain pasta.
Controversial idea. Get the hot and spicy one, cook some chicken with it, like some chicken breast pieces, and douse it in really thick Bisto gravy.
Bisto gravy?
Honestly, it's life-changing.
Okay. Well, actually, one thing we watched back when we were watching back the last week's weekly vlog, I really loved that creamy chicken pasta. No, the salmon and the mussels pasta with the cooking wine. That was nice. I think we should possibly have that again. I can hear a meow.
Yeah, I heard a shout.
I heard a shout from what sounds like a little baby. Where are you? There you are. Hello. What are you after, little? Is it dinner time? Okay, I think it might be your dinner time. Well, I think you've got some food already down, to be honest. Shall we have a look outside? Because sometimes he wants to show me outside. So this is obviously evening time. The sun always sets over there in our garden. So nothing so much has changed since the last weekly vlog because I literally only filmed the last garden update about an hour or so before upload, so nothing's really changed. But I did want to show you today just how beautiful the garden looks this time of night at sunset, basically. And it does look really, 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 really lovely. And the road, just how the light comes through the rose walk, looks really delightful. Anyway, I'm going to go now. I think I'm required to do some salad. Right, so here is my contribution to the meal. I have sliced the pitas. They are wholemeal because they didn't have the white one, so we've had to
be healthy.
We weren't being healthy, we were forced to be healthy. And I've done some salad, so obviously these are garden tomatoes and garden cucumber with some salad dressing, which is nice. What, the whole meal?
The bread.
Okay, I'll have mine later with dinner. Here is what actually would you call this concoction?
Peri peri chicken.
Just peri peri chicken. It does look nice, it smells nice. Just had a comment on our last vlog telling us how to cook the perfect eggs.
Ooh.
So you part fry them.
Right.
Then apparently you put some water in.
Okay.
Put a lid on. And apparently it's a foolproof way of having perfect runny eggs.
We need a lid for that pan then.
We need to get a lid. Yeah. And we haven't got a pan with a lid, have we? Not of that size.
Not a frying pan, though.
We haven't. That's what we need. Anyway, dinner's almost ready, so... But I just thought I'd tell you that foolproof way. I forgot we were having chips as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yummy, yummy.
Fake Nando's.
Yeah, it is a bit like a fake Nando's. I agree. It is. Yummy, yummy.
There we go.
And there is the chicken all finished. Delicious. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Wednesday. I've just come outside to have my morning coffee, and there's an aeroplane almost right over the house. And I've just looked it up on my flight tracker app, and I think this one has come all the way from Puerto Rico, which is where we're going on our cruise in January. So it's come a long way, and I think it's heading towards Amsterdam. But anyway, here I am this morning. It's a big, bright, sunny, beautiful day, I could probably do getting some washing on the go. And then I've got some jobs to do in terms of setting up a few things for our new venture. Yes, we are. I keep teasing. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to tease. But it is something that we're doing, and I want to keep it quiet until we launch. And then it kind of has a bit more impact. You'll see exactly what I mean when it happens. But yes, I need to get going. I do. On my second cup of coffee of the morning. Now, in last week's vlog, I couldn't remember what this massive, beautiful rose was called, and I got it mixed up with Queen Mother. I think this is Princess Alexandra of Kent. I really do. Anyway, it's gorgeous, and it's still in bloom. We have Molly. Hello, Molly. How are you doing, sweetie? I know Beau is reclining on a patio slab. Hello, lovely. Right, so I think it's finally time to say goodbye to the birthday balloon. They've all kind of flopped. So let's get rid. Oh, I'm thinking don't move while I get the camera out. So Molly was lounging in the sunbeam. See, Beau and Molly both love sunbeams. They do bond over sunbeams. And Beau's just crept into the cardboard box and is quietly sat next to her. So we do have some harmony some of the time. They're not always at each other's throats. Sometimes they just don't understand each other. But now we have a moment of peace, a breakthrough. Right, so what's the plan of action for today? We've got something special coming. A drone coming. Ooh, woohoo! We'll be able to do some proper professional drone footage. Yeah. But it's coming at what time?
Between 2:45 and 5:45. And I've got the gym.
Yeah, so that presents a problem because I've got to stay in, which I am anyway, because I'm working on some things. So we've got the quandary of, do we wait to go out and get food for tonight's evening meal, or does Matt get it from after he's finished the gym? But we don't know what to have.
No.
But I've got a secret. I've downloaded a brand new app.
Ooh.
So it's full of magazines. It's basically an entire app of magazines.
Oh, is it that Readly?
Yeah, it's the one I was telling you about the other week. Remember I said last week that we were looking for things and I wanted, maybe there was like a magazine or something?
Yeah.
Online, I found an app, it's Readly, and I am gonna have a look now and see if we can find a recipe for tonight.
Back from the gym.
I'm so sweaty.
Yes, he's worked out very good circuit training today.
Yes, and I hate it.
But something special's come. Yay, we have a drone. Woohoo. Tear it. It is a
DJI Mini 2 SE.
It is a DJI Mini 2 SE. There we go. So it only weighs how much?
250 grams.
Ooh.
249 grams.
There we go.
And you have a bag and some batteries.
And you know someone who's got one.
Yes, I do. My personal trainer.
And he says it's really good. And there's different settings. You can have it in spiral mode. Apparently you can go 30 miles an hour.
On speed mode.
Yeah. So we'll test this out. I'm not sure if the batteries will already be charged, but we'll see.
But if not, I'll plug them in while I go for a shower.
Tiny. Just look at that. It all just fits in there. Is that the battery? So the actual drone. No, that must be the control then.
This is all.
Oh yeah, that's the control. You can just about see it. And it all fits nice and neat in the carry case. Tiny.
That is diddy.
That is so tiny. Ah, so it must all open out, I imagine, when you turn it on. Interesting. Yeah. So this is the battery pack. There's three batteries that go into this little holder, and we think it charges them individually. So once it's charged that one, we think it'll move on to the next one. But obviously we just need one to get it flying for our test flight. And it's plugged into our little socket under there. We have a USB socket in our kitchen.
Like to do a test flight. Ooh. Oh, wow. We've taken flight. Have you got it on a mode or something?
No, I've just...
Are you controlling that?
Yeah.
Wow.
And we can see.
Oh, look, you can see. That's the camera. Wow. Oh, we'll be able to take some good footage with this. Oh, it's going up.
Oh, don't send it too high in case it comes crashing down.
It won't, don't worry.
So apparently it's got a return home feature as well. I'm trying to zoom in on it.
That's a bit high.
Oh, wow. That's very high. What can you see now from the screen?
All across the golf course.
Oh, wow. That's really cool. Can it see us if you, like, tilt the camera down? Ah, there we are.
There we are.
Oh, wow.
And there's Bobo.
Oh, wow. That's really cool. Wow, so you can get some really good aerial shots. That's amazing. The light, it is scary.
It's terrifying.
It is scary, because also they cost a lot of money, and like if you crash them on your first flight, you're... So yeah, we're not going to take it over the pond, over the big pool. We're not taking it over there. Can you imagine if it came crashing down over the pool?
It's noisier than I thought.
Yeah, it sounds like a big bee, like a big wasp. That's what it sounds like. Like a big noisy insect. Oh, we're going to attempt our first landing.
Kind of, I want to get.
Oh, hang on. Should we see if you can land? Oh, look, there's us. It can see us. Oh, that's really cool.
Right, let me press the button on the phone to land.
Oh, so it's got automatic landing?
Yes.
Oh, wow, let's see if it lands. There we go. Go down, nice and safe. Oh, that's really cool. Did it.
Yay.
You did it. Did you enjoy that?
Scared.
It is scary. It is very scary, to be quite honest.
Oh, there's a...
Oh, what is there?
There's a dead mouse.
Oh, no. One of the cats have been... Oh, no. Oh. Mm. But, on a lighter note, we've had a successful first flight.
Very noisy.
Yeah, but it's still... Yeah, it worked. That's the main thing. Ah, I'm moving out the way. Ah, it's coming after me. Ah, that's really cool though. I'm standing safely away. Come on, oh, Bo is very interested. Look at this. You won't be able to catch that, my sweetie. We're just sort of flying over the village. It's really, really weird. Went really well. The cats are very intrigued because it's like a big massive bumblebee that's flying around, but it does record really well. But we haven't got an SD card, so unfortunately we couldn't record anything that it took. But I did think you can actually do a screen record, so the next time we do a flight, if we haven't got an SD card, we'll put the screen record on and then show you.
That was fun.
It was.
Terrifying.
It was terrifying, but it was
fun. Hi, Molly. How are you?
So, I've got my coffee and I'm outside. I'm not going to lie. The drone was scary. It's a good job that Matt was flying it, because I think I'd have had a mild panic. But anyway, basically the purpose... Let's look at Molly while I talk, because she's gorgeous, aren't you, lady? So the purpose of it is for work. So whenever we do a show home... or anything of that nature, we can drone if required to do so. But also anything in the future, if we're going anywhere nice and scenic, we can drone. By the way, there are different categories of drones. I think it goes on size. So the one that we've got, you don't need a license for, which is excellent, because I think big size ones, you have to have a license for. So that one, you don't. And of course, there are certain places where you can't drone, but normally you're sort of aware of that. But anyway, we'll be able to use it for work purposes and to be able to get some really nice scenery for the vlogs, which we haven't really been able to do before. So, and it'll also be handy for any upcoming projects that we have in the pipeline.
And Matt's made a
Would you say it's a curry or more of a Chinese?
It's a Chinese curry.
A Chinese curry, but it does smell gorgeous. It has been an absolutely foul morning. Welcome to Friday. It's been raining. In fact, it's actually a really brief period where it stopped raining. The cats have not been very happy. I've not been very happy, not been able to go out and have my morning constitutional coffee. But the garden is still looking very nice. Anyway, I am going to take a break now. I'm going to make myself a coffee, sit down in here, and look at the garden at least. If I can't go out and enjoy it, at least I'm going to look at it. So I think I've showed you which coffee we have before. So this, we use the Nescafe Gold Blend Smooth. Got to be the smooth and silky. It is the best instant coffee that I think I've ever had. And I also use the Demerara sugar as well. Now, I know, I kind of want to get into kind of ground coffee bean coffee, but in the matter of sort of not being bothered, this is really, really good coffee. I have got to tell you about this brand new app that I've discovered, and it's called Readly. Yes, it's pronounced Readly. And I've been trying recently to think of ways to relax and chill. After I had my episode of Bell's Palsy, one of the things I wanted to do was read a lot more. And I bought a reading book, and that kind of hasn't worked out for me. A big reading book seems to be a big commitment. So what I've been looking for is ways to kind of get reading in, relax in those 5, 10, 15 minutes that you have available throughout the day. And I think I found the perfect thing. It's called Readly. And as you can see from the screen grab that I'm popping on the screen now, there are so many different choices and categories of magazines, and you've got them all on your device, in your pocket at any single time. There are food magazines, gossip magazines, there are newspapers. You can look at the newspapers in different languages, so it doesn't matter what country you're from. If I just click on newspapers, you can see they're by region, they are by country. It's absolutely incredible. Everything all in one place. You can even have your own download so that when you're not connected to the internet, everything is there ready for you. If I just click into, for example, a gossip magazine, there's all the latest on Harry and Meghan, which I'm quite interested in. And if you just want to explore, I mean, I typed in the other day, royalty, look at all of the different royal magazines going on, garden news. I mean, there's so many different gardening magazines. There's everything you can possibly imagine. Plus, you are saving the environment because there is no paper waste. And that is one thing that I think I'm trying to be a lot more conscious of in our daily life, is that we're not wasting as much. We're not being as wasteful. I have got a discount code and link. It's in our description box, and it does give you 2 months of all of these magazines for free, and you can cancel at any time. Right, what am I going to choose now? I mean, I think I'm going to have to look at some gardening. So as you can see in the magazines, you can get the full articles, which you can pull out like that. You can even rotate so that everything is as it would be. You can pinch and zoom. The features are absolutely incredible. Maureen's been naughty. Look what she's done. Look what Maureen has done. She's given herself away to the Colonel. That's what she's done. She's a floozy.
She's floozy. Yeah,
we've also been to... We went to Morrison's with the intention of buying something to cook tonight.
But nothing took our
We hands. Wandered around that store aimlessly, and we couldn't find a thing. So we bought a tablecloth. I always like a disposable tablecloth.
And some Chinese five spice.
Some Chinese five spice. Some toilet wipes, because everyone likes to be clean and fresh. And a couple of bleaches and some beans and hoops. And Maureen also wanted a pack of hobnobs, because she got through her last ones quite quickly.
Oh,
Maureen, you're terrible. You really are. Really terrible. So we're going to go now and deliver Maureen's bag of KFC to her.
Hi everybody, do not adjust your sets. I am in a different outfit. I'm actually in some clothes that I bought for the cruise last year, and I don't think I've worn them particularly since. So I've got my green kind of khaki shorts on, I've got my Toms on, I've got this nice shirt, I have got my Tahitian pearl. If I show you the jewellery, I've got my kind of beads on. We are off to a barbecue. We're going to a friend's barbecue. So I might be able to get a bit of footage because he's going to man the barbecue. But there's Matt. He's lost his sunglasses. He didn't know where they were. Were they in the car?
Yes.
So we've packed a bag of stuff. We're only going for a few hours, to be honest. but we've got a massive... Who else does this? You go somewhere for literally a few hours, but you take a massive bag full of stuff. Mm. I've got my sun creams. I've got my sun hat. We don't know what the weather's going to be like because it's been cloudy, it's been sunny, it's been all over the place. So we've had to prepare for all different eventualities.
On Bo is sat on a pile of our stuff and my laptop bag. Yes, he is. I'll just show you what I mean about... Oh, there's Rory in there. And Molly is on my towel that I got out of the shower and dropped on the floor, and she sat on it, so I can't move it. Anyway, I'll move it when we're back. So look at the clouds. They're very, very grey, and then it's been sunny, and it's been all over the place. My parents came this morning. Just passing a sign for the Battle of Bosworth Field. Anyway, we are about 7 miles away from our destination, and it's been a journey because we've gone through a massive diversion. We went to a big road and then it was shut, so we had to come all the way back round, and then a massive diversion. We passed a really interesting maze. So it's a maze that you can call at that's made out of maize, like a big crop circle type thing. So that might be something nice to go to a different time. But yeah, we need to now get to this barbecue.
And we made it. Yay. That was a very fraught journey.
Right, let's go.
So we're here, and Nick normally criticises our barbecue and calls it an outdoor grill. So this is a proper one. It's nice to actually see. Look, I don't think it's been used. So he's just lined it with foil. And there's a bag, a coal bag. I think you have to light the coal bag and then it all just happens. Magic happens. So we'll see what happens. Oh, there's another one coming as well. Let's see it in situ. There we go. We're going to have to show everyone how this works. Right, we're going to light. This could either go spectacularly wrong or it's going to work. And we're not quite sure which. I think it might take a while to actually light.
There we go, we have flame. Man has lit flame. There we go. We have fire. We're cooking. It's like medieval cavemen. That's what
there
we are.
There we go. It's actually doing it. Well, hey, we will have food today. We're all settled. We've got our drinks. We've got our ice and slice. I've got a gin. Matt's got wine. We're doing well. We've got some barbecue thighs. And we've got some Chinese chicken drumsticks. Look at that meat. Wow. That is a lot of meat you've got on your barbecue, Nick. Cooking. It smells nice. It smells lovely.
There we go. It's going to be a taste sensation. Look at all that meat.
Just played Mario Party.
Right, we are at the local next because we need to go shopping for a couple of outfits, don't we? We need at least 3 decent outfits for something that we've got coming up. So let's go and find some.
With the crypticness, it is being revealed like in the next couple of weeks.
So. Yeah, something is happening very, very soon, but we need to keep a little bit hush-hush at the moment. Yes. But we do need some outfits, so we need to go and find some.
Give the reveal date.
What's our reveal date?
30th of September.
The 30th of September, there you go. That's our reveal date.
So we found our outfits, but just walking through the bed linen, we saw this really cute duvet. And there's a bit of weird strobe lighting going on, but that is so cute.
We've just spotted for the first time the autumn decor creeping in. There's just a little quick preview of what's
on offer in the next home. Hi. It's been a busy day for me. No, it has been.
Excuse me.
Let's run down your day then. What have you done this morning? You got up.
And then I got showered and dressed before you were even awake.
Yeah, you went to get cat litter.
I did. And then we realised we were out of tray liners. So I had to go back out for tray liners. Yeah. And then we went and did some clothes shopping.
No, you missed one thing out. You went and got all the bits for what you're doing right now.
Oh, yes, I also did the food shop.
Because a few days ago, I said, oh, you know, I could really fancy some roast potatoes and a roast dinner. So Matt got all the bits to do a roast dinner.
I don't listen.
No, you do listen. And you also said, I never give you enough praise. So I'm going to give you all the praise because you did listen. And you're preparing a beautiful roast dinner, which we're going to enjoy later. And I've been doing things as well today. I've done some laundry and washing because we've got cleaning to do tomorrow.
And I'm going to go in a minute and try and get some of the whitewashing in. I've washed my dressing gown as well. It's all been going on, it really has. So I need to edit the vlog that you're watching now, part of it, because I need to get my new phone working. I've actually bought an Apple iPhone Pro Max. So I need to get that going, but I didn't want to risk losing any footage during the transfer, so I need to edit what you're watching now and then transfer it over just to protect it so it doesn't get lost. And I need to change the cat trays. There's all things going on. It's just been a busy kind of Sunday day.
But just look at the glorious sunshine, and there is the whitewashing flapping and blowing around in the breeze. It really is. It has been warm. I mean, it's been the sort of weather where you need to put your sun cream on. You really do. I've also harvested some more tomatoes as well. Yeah, it's been quite a productive day. Oh, hi, lady. What are you doing sat on the washing that I've just folded up? Oh, she always does it, don't you? You always do it. Yes, you do. Roast potatoes are coming along. They're not done yet, but look. Yummy, yummy. Now, Matt's made his Yorkshire pudding recipe, batter. So, do you want to tell people what it is? People always ask about
it. Yes, it's just equal parts flour, eggs and milk with a little sprinkling of salt and vinegar. Mix it all together, whisk it up, strain it into a jug. You're done.
There you go. But we think this pan has a lot to do with how fluffy they get. It's a Scoville. And it's a really good non-stick pan. So Matt just made a very strong claim. He's just said that he thinks these roast potatoes could possibly be the best ones he's ever made.
Well, they're certainly the nicest looking ones.
They do look rather good.
They look rather golden.
They do, they look very golden. And that is one of the things that I was kind of craving. Matt just said another very bold statement. He said we need some new oven gloves. He can't live like this.
I can't live using a tea towel.
No, but we did have an oven mitt.
We did, but it's not very good.
No, so do you want like a traditional oven glove?
A double ender.
You want a double-ended oven glove, okay. Yes. Well, if anyone's got any suitable recommendations for some good ones, some good double enders, then do let us know in the comment section below. Here they come! Ooh. Look at the size of those! I'm going to have to say it. They're Whoppers!
Absolute Whoppers! Which ones do you want?
That is a meal in itself. Christ. I mean, I could keep one for a snack later. We could keep one for a snack. Is that a no? Oh, look at that. You couldn't get that better in a carvery if you tried. Just look. Matt's had three. I've saved my Yorkshire pudding for a snack later, my third one.
That's enough gravy, dear.
Ooh, yeah, looks lovely. Thank you. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Monday. And we have got such a busy day ahead of us. Just look at the mess. So last night, or yesterday, I did some washing. So I've got to put all the washing away. We need to do a lot of tidying, cleaning, because we have something important happening tomorrow that involves doing something in this area in the house. So again, apologies for being cryptic, but all will be revealed. There will be a big reveal and all will make sense. Bo, as you can see, he still eats from the island. We've tried on the floor. He just prefers to eat on the island. But anyway, this is a mess we've got to do. We've got to clean the rest of the house. I need to clean the bathroom. Matt's having lunch. I'll probably have my lunch once I've cleaned, because I get very hot. So I like to do all the really busy jobs before I have my shower. So I need to clean the bathroom because that's a really busy job, and vacuum. Matt normally does the dusting and windows and mirrors. And then yesterday I did all the cat trays and cleaned all those out. So we kind of share the jobs equally. I also need to come outside later on today. Normally do that early evening, and I'll do some deadheading of the roses and the flowers. My mum has been already and had a cup of coffee. I'm just it's the anticipation of all the stuff we've got to do today. Plus we need to learn something. There's a bit of a script that we need to learn as well. So, well, not learn, we need to rehearse it, because there's going to be a prompter thing. Anyway, it's all happening tomorrow, but we need to get ready for tomorrow. That is the gist of where we're at right now. So my first job is to take all this stuff upstairs and put it away. Everything needs to go in its correct place. Right, so it's now time to vacuum upstairs. So I do have a Dyson, one of the cordless ones, which I use to kind of spot messes. But when I'm doing any deep cleaning, I use the Shark. Now, what I didn't know when I bought the Shark is that with the sorts of carpet pile that we've got, quite thick, it is quite difficult to push. So it's a bit of a workout when I vacuum, but I normally have this setting put on open so that it's less suction. And then I have it, obviously, this one set on carpets there. But look, I emptied this yesterday because I vacuumed downstairs yesterday. So this is empty. It is a really good picker-upper. Whenever I go over these carpets, you would be amazed at the amount of fluff and cat hair and all sorts of things it picks up. So let's give it a whirl and just see from this bedroom what we pick up. This is just from one room. Just look at all the fluff. You'd think I haven't hoovered and vacuumed. You'd think I hadn't literally vacuumed for months, but just look at all of this. It's really incredible what it picks up. So I just found this National Trust handbook, and we are still members, whilst I was going through some things and tidying up. It just made me realise we haven't been to a National Trust property in absolutely forever. Literally cannot remember the last time we went. I probably vlogged it, but there are so many different places that you can go, so it's just a reminder. I'm keeping this, I'm not throwing it away, that we need to get out there and see some more properties and gardens. I'm vlogging for prosperity because I've never seen this corner so empty and clean. Literally, we've had everything out.
It's all here.
Yeah, it's all here, so it's all got to find its way back. But I would, yeah, we need to sort of dust it all as it goes back in, I think, as well. But we're going to have a sink full of bleach eventually, get everyone bleached. Yay. I am so hot. But yeah, it's all looking a lot cleaner and tidier. And there we go. One fresh, clean and tidy bathroom. So there we have it. The kitchen and the rest of the house is all nice and spotless. Just look how tidy this is compared to what I showed you this morning. Just look. Ah.
There we go. Kent, and our job was tidying.
Yes, we were tidying was the name of the game today. So we've had the bifolds opened, airing the house, making it all nice and fresh. Here's one last look at the garden, and then I think we need to sign out today. Okay, so there we have it for another week. Thank you for this rather eclectic vlog, and hopefully next week we'll be able to reveal something. So thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed it, please give it a big old thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, comment, all the rest of it.
Hit the bell.
Hit the bell. And from us, mwah, to you all, and goodbye.
Bye, guys.